We bought everything. The house, its contents, the car, and the overgrown yard.
Before renovations can begin, it's up to us to sort it all out.
Hey everybody, you're about to see us gather up some of the artwork and go through the record cabinet. It was a dark and rainy day, so some of the pictures are a little dim. If you stay till the end, we're going to go through some of the better pieces we found when it was sunny out, and you'll get a better look at some of the things we found.
$0.50 New York State Lottery.
1973.
Wow. Think it's a winner?
I hope so.
Double lotto. Get the house and the lottery ticket. These drawings were on the wall. They're dated 1925.
What?
And they're on hooks that are painted.
That are what?
Painted.
I bet they've been here.
So I wonder if these came with the house.
Probably. I'm sure some of the stuff must have.
I have no idea. It says 1925 on it.
Here we have some more dated 1925, and we believe it may be her father. I think he was an artist as well. You see that date there?
Pulled them off the wall and the hooks were like painted on there, like they had
just always been there.
Been there, yeah.
Can you see if you can open this?
It's really weird. It's like a guy making puppets.
Oh, that is weird. Interesting. It's a super cool frame on that. Look how old that frame is.
I can't open it.
There's probably nothing in it, but...
can't get it.
It's trash.
Oh, there might be something better here.
Okay.
I'll tell you this.
That's probably paper clips.
Yeah, I mean,
so I was right that the can was full of paper clips, but didn't know this was in there.
Yeah, I think it says Winchester 45, but that's not a 45. Pretty interesting find.
So we have a couple of figurines up here that we found. This was a beautiful soapstone called the Happy Fisherman.
Do you think any of this old sheet music is any good?
We should wipe this thing out. This is pretty cool.
This is a thermometer. It's got a tiny, tiny little thermometer.
Oh my gosh. That's so small.
This is worth saving.
Look at the little feet.
It's been glued, hot glued.
Oh, look at the feet on it there.
Yeah. Oh, there's some kind of maker's thing in there.
This one's pretty old.
Kittinger?
Yeah.
I guess we'll save it and see if the antique buyers want it.
More art going to take down. This looks like World War I, maybe a discharge paper or enlistment paper. Same with this one, something in French. And this is a war bond for World War I. So this is a
basically a pass to move around during World War I that was issued by kind of like a police department.
These are sketches. They look like original model sketches for somebody to do something in bronze or...
Again, we think it might be her father's work. Talented family.
Plaster or something. I love this one. Don't know what it is, but I want to look it up. This one's really cool. I don't know if you can read that name there, if there's anybody who can read French or knows French art. I believe these are original sketches for fashion designs. You see here, this is a little hand-drawn sketch. And then there is a little coloring in on it. So I'm gonna have to learn more about that. We have several of them here. Very interesting. Oh, that's the back. Okay, so that's the back of the dress. Here's another one. Very cool.
Super cool. I love any nautical themes.
Show you some of the artwork up close. Okay, so this painting was hanging up in the hallway upstairs. You may remember where we found the snakeskin. The signature is, looks like Faye Anderson, 68. So that was a period of time where Marie was living in New York City. We think this is another Marie original. This was hanging upstairs in the guest room, and we found that hat next to the painting, so we think it might be a self-portrait. Here again is another Marie original, dated 1956. This looks like it's signed.
We believe this is a lithograph, and it does have a date of 1947 on it.
There does appear to be a signature down at the bottom. This one we think is a Marie original. It looks like pencil and watercolor. Over here we have another one that is pencil, but it looks like it may have a watercolor background. But we don't believe this is hers because there is a date on it of 1921. And we have this piece here. Again, looks like a colored pencil.
Gonna go through the record cabinet. We have a Fisher stereo. We haven't looked it up yet. AM, FM, cassette, plus record player in there. With some Fisher speakers. Haven't looked any of that up. Don't know if that stuff's still collectible or not. All right, let's see what we have. Cool. I found a little mini tape recorder. You can smell through your mask. Original Time Life membership to a record collection. I found the envelope where they mail it to her house, like Netflix before it was Netflix. That's really interesting. I know we're in a hurry to run. What in the world? Notre Dame. Gigantic postcard from Notre Dame. Whoa, a bunch of Russian records. See that? It looks like it's, I think that's Russian. Thank you. of the gypsy violins. I bet you like that. I'll set that one aside. Armenian wedding music. Hungarian gypsy music.
I didn't have that record.
You do? Oh, it's broken. Amico. Bedouin tribal songs. Neil Diamond. Darn, doesn't have Sweet Caroline, but still, Neil Diamond. So these were a really neat find. I thought they were giant postcards, but it turns out that they're records. I guess you put it on the record player, if you see the circle there. It'll spin. I have no idea what it's going to play, but I guess we can try it at home. I have a record player. I don't know if it's the sounds of the city or what it's supposed to be. It's all in French. Pretty cool stuff. To look out my front window. Looks like I'm in South America or something.
Okay, so I went through some of those records. It was kind of dark because it was raining out, got cloudy and late in the day. So I want to go back over some of the other ones that stood out to me and see if maybe you enjoy them too. Let's take a look. This one looks like a lot of fun. And here's a close-up of the Neil Diamond, a very close-up video of Neil Diamond.